Hey everybody and welcome back to Relax My Dog. I hope you're all well and looking forward to this week's video. Today me and Milo here are going to be talking about the basic first aid for dogs. Obviously if anything ever happens to your dog, you want to make sure you are as prepared as ever to be able to help them in any way possible. Today we are going to be talking about the basic needs of first aid in terms of the kit that you should have prepared for your dog and also how to resuscitate your dog as well. Both very, very key things if you are a dog owner. So yeah, let's get started. Before we get started as well, I also want to apologise. Milo is extremely tired at the moment. He's just come back from a 2-hour walk, so he's ready for bed. As you can see, he's lay on the sofa behind me. He's actually really, really far back, bless him, just so that the light isn't as bright for him. But before we get started, definitely do go down below and let us know what sort of dog breed you have. Obviously, here at Relax My Dog, we absolutely love to know what sort of dogs we are helping in terms of the music we are producing. So definitely do let us know down below what your dog breed is, because we are very, very interested and we absolutely love reading the comments here. So yeah, let's get started. Okay, so first we're going to talk about the kit that you should have. These are sort of quick fire things that you should make sure that you have, just like a checklist. The first thing you should have is bandages for your dog if anything ever happens and you need to wrap something up on their paw, etc. Make sure you have bandages on hand, whether they're for your family or for your dog. You need to make sure you have them on hand. You also need to make sure you have non-adhesive absorbent dressings as well, to make sure that you're also further prepared to help your dog in any situation. You should also have surgical tape to be able to tie anything up. Like I say, these are very basic that you should have sort of in your first aid for your family as well. You should also have cotton wool. Blunt scissors are very important, as well as a thick towel if you ever need that on hand too. Another thing that you can also have, if you're extra cautious in your house, is to get your dog their very own cone. If they do have sort of a sore or they have a rash and you need to keep them away from it, if you have a cone yourself, whether you get them from a local vet or you purchase them, these can be very, very beneficial to make sure that they aren't touching that area at all. So yeah, a cone is very, very important as well. So that is sort of the basis of what you should have in your very own kit if you do own a dog. Now we're going to move on to a few top tips if you ever find yourself in a sort of a situation that you don't really want to be in with your dog. The main tip is to just keep calm in any situation. I know if you are in a stressful situation with your dog, you aren't going to be able to keep calm. But believe me, keeping calm is the best thing that you can do for yourself and also for your dog. Your dog can pick up on so many different types of energies from you. So if you're showing sort of a stressed energy towards them, they might get more stressed than they already are. So keeping as calm and collected as possible is one of the most important things to do if your dog is in a certain situation. As well as this, it's important to stay calm to make sure you're doing everything correct. Obviously, if you are flustered and you're wanting to help your dog as much as possible, they may become quite anxious and they may also bite you as well if you are trying to sort of help them. Plus, if you are taking your time, you're being calm, you're going to do something a lot better than you would do if you were rushing and if you were stressing out. A little top tip as well is if you ever do find yourself in a certain situation, definitely do check out the Blue Cross. That is an online website which talks about so many different situations that you can find yourself in, whether your dog has stopped breathing, anything that you particularly have. If you pop onto the Blue Cross, they have loads and loads of different things, step-by-step guides into what you can do. But now we're going to move on to a quick basic dog resuscitation. I'm going to be trying to include a few little clips here and there that I'm going to be doing to Milo, but obviously Milo isn't unconscious, he is absolutely fine. So the first tip is to put your dog on their side. Obviously, if your dog is laying on their front or laying on their back, it can be difficult for anything to come up from their airways, so definitely do put them on their side. Plus you can get control over their body as well when they're in this position. The next one is to check that the dog's breathing has actually stopped. If it hasn't, there are many other methods that you can use, because obviously you don't want to be blocking any airways during that process, but this one is specific if your dog has stopped breathing. The one way to check this is to get a hair, you can get it from your dog. Obviously, if I were to stroke Milo once, a handful of hair will come out. Just get that piece of hair, pop it over their noses and check if they are breathing. If they're breathing, it will move. If they're not breathing, it will stand still. So this next step, make sure you are extremely careful, as you will need to open your dog's mouth and pull their tongue forward and make sure that there's nothing blocking their airways, blocking their mouth. If there is, you'll need to remove this. And obviously throughout this step, make sure you are being careful that you are not being bitten, because I'm sure a dog in that situation might be quite stressed. So the next step is, if your dog doesn't wake up during this process, doesn't start breathing again when you've removed anything from their airways, this next one is to close your dog's mouth and hold it over their mouth. Milo has quite a long spout, so we can hold that quite easily, and you have to start blowing into their nose. It's recommended to do this 20 times per minute and get into sort of rhythm whilst doing this. And if you then can't feel any sort of heartbeat, it is recommended that you push on your dog's chest every second just behind their front legs. Obviously, if they're on our side, you can have direct access to where their ribs are and where their heart would be. It's recommended that every 2 breaths that you blow into your dog's nose, you should be doing 15 compressions onto your dog's chest. Obviously, you would never ever want to be in this situation, but it is always important to be prepared for this, because you want to be able to know that if anything happens to your dog, you are somewhat prepared. I know it's very difficult to say you are fully prepared for this to happen, but you are somewhat prepared for this to happen. So I really do hope you enjoyed this video. If you find yourself a little bit more prepared, then definitely do let us know down below. Also, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you did enjoy this. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel down below. Thank you all so much for helping us reach 300,000 subscribers. That is absolutely incredible. So thank you so much for anyone that has subscribed or is about to subscribe. Also, don't forget to click the post notifications bell, which is just next door to the subscribe button down below. We also have our Relax My Dog t-shirts, as you can see here. All you need to do to enter one of our t-shirts is pop over to your Instagram, post a picture of you and your dog, or just you on your own, the funnier the better, and you have therefore entered this giveaway. Don't forget to tag us at Relax My Dog as well. And that is it for this week's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.